I end this episode on Toy Story 2, Buzz Lightyear to the Rescue, another game I had as a kid but never finished, although I did get closer than I did with Pac-Man World. The film it's based on was only the second film I ever saw in a cinema, and it was during the ads I saw this game. I thought it was the coolest looking thing, and a few weeks later I had a pirate copy. I don't think anyone knew back then who had a PS1 didn't have theirs chipped. Of course the one I'm playing now is a legitimate copy. Story matches the film, the owner of the big toy shop has pinched Woody to sell him an all merch related toy show to a museum. There's obviously more to the film, but this game just deals with Buzz's rescue mission. We start the game and are given the level select screen, drawn on it, which is a nice touch. Only level to choose is Andy's house. This is one of those old movie licensed PS1 games that link levels with random, non-spoilery, not always connected to the level, clips from the film itself. In fact, all three Pixar games on the PS1 did this, and I'm not going to show any of them because I don't want to risk a smiting from the copyright fuckers. But yeah, level 1, Andy's house. I start in the bedroom, this game is a standard 3D collectathon platformer. I can fire Buzz's laser, double jump by popping his wings out, spin his body around to whack enemies with his wings, and aim in first person, which shows reflections of Buzz's face in his helmet. I'd forgotten about that, I hadn't played this game in nearly 20 years. I get on the bookshelf and push this massive book over to make a ramp up to Andy's bed, jump across the bedside table to the drawers, climb up the pole, ride the zipline to Molly's cot, why it's in Andy's room I don't know, and shoot the locks to open it and get out. A decent way to get reacquainted with how the game works. I go down the stairs into the living room, do a foot stomp on the chair to get to the shelf in the corner where I find Mr. Potato Head's eye. I then go along the top of these shelves to view the corner where I find one of Bo Peep's missing sheep. On the settee is Ham, who will trade me 50 of those coins dotted around the levels for a pizza plank token. These tokens are the main collectible of the game, there are 5 in each level, one of them always being giving Ham 50 coins. And each future level needs a certain amount of tokens to unlock. Next I go down into the basement, there's raw sewage being pumped down here for some reason. I give Potato Head his ear back and he lets me have the cosmic shield that makes me invincible for a little bit and lets me walk over that sewage. He's also pretty ugly in this game, look at that sinister grin. I cross the sewage and start climbing these boxes, go across the gap and up these shelves and then ride a zipline to another sheep. I go back up to the shelves and instead jump across the lights of these bigger boxes that I push into place so I can jump up to the highest shelf and get my first Pizza Planet token of the game. Whenever you pick up a token, you're given the choice to leave the level. Me, being a dumb 7-year-old, would do that with every token and then get annoyed when I didn't have enough to continue the game. Out of the basement and into the kitchen, I climb up onto the side and work my way along to the fridge. I use that to get on top of these cupboards and go across them to find another sheep. Well, Peep's on the table in here too, she lets me know there's 5 missing sheep in total. That's another constant across the levels, someone who's lost 5 of something and will give me a token for finding them. Now I have enough coins to give Ham for the second token of this level. Next I'm going into the garage for the cat flap. I start by climbing the shelves where Andy's mum left the power tools going. Past the drills I can get onto this dustbin and then the car. From there I can jump across to the big light to another shelf where I swing across a series of bars to find the 4 sheep. Once I get down I find RC, who challenges me to a 3-lap race around the car. It's easy, he spins out once and I don't see him again until halfway through the 3rd lap, where I get in front of him to make him stop for a bit and I win. My award of course being the 3rd Pizza Planet token. I go back up the stairs where Rex tells me the tin robot boss is in the attic, so I climb up in and push this block into place. I then climb onto the centre box and challenge the boss. I just have to dodge it while it tries ramming me until it stops and then shoot it in the back. Being the first boss it's really easy, taking just 3 hits to kill. He drops the 4th token. I go back to the box I pushed and use it to climb up to the top of the attic where I find the last sheep. I return them to Bo Peep for the last token and leave the level. There's just a nice introduction to the game, nothing frustrating, good music, everything easy enough to find without being dull. After leaving the level I get a nice result screen showing me I got everything. Level 2 is Andy's neighbourhood. We start off in what I assume is Andy's back garden where the lawnmower's going off on its own. Or are they sentient beings like the toys? There's a soldier hiding in these molehills and I have to use the foot stomp on them all to get him out. He sets off a flare from the one he's in and then I have to get to that one quickly. Once I've done them all, I've saved him. I leave the garden and find a power up I cannot use, and Potato Head isn't in this level so it looks like I'm going to have to come back later to fully complete it. Or do I? I also run into Rex again. Rex is in every level and he exists to let you know what tokens you're missing. I climb up onto the swing set and find another army man and then climb the rope onto the tire swing up into the tree where Ham is. I keep on climbing and find another army man and then fall. I decide to do the rest of that later and go through the hole in this fence into another garden where I inflate this rubber duck which then jumps into the pool. I get on it and use a foot stomp to make it bounce high enough for me to reach the first token of this level. I jump across the plants in this garden and push up on this plank of wood to make a ramp to another plant. Climb that and make my way to another plant where I find army man number 4. I leave his garden and go through another hole into another garden in the opposite corner of the level. I press this switch to make the car start bouncing and then I climb up this washing machine on the other side and make a ramp up to the washing line. I zipline across all 3 of them to find the final army man in the basket. I then pound on the car's boom and find out that's how I was supposed to get to the washing machine. I go back to Andy's garden and return the army man to Sarge, who gives me my second token. I then leave and challenge RC to another race. Now, I shouldn't be able to win this yet, I should need the item I can't get, but instead I just stay in front of RC and keep making him stop. If I can minimize backtracking in any way, I will. Things get scary when he passes under me while jumping, but he spins out of the last bit of water inches before the goal and I just manage it, netting me token 3. Now it's time to start climbing that tree again. I get the 4th token from Ham, now I have enough coins, and fall at the same spot I did last time. I make the jump the next time and grab this rope, lowering it and creating a shortcut, a much needed shortcut considering how much falling I do afterwards. Eventually I make it to the top where the Zerg kite is waiting. It flies around and I have to use the first person aiming when it stops to shoot it. After that it just tries to spin into me. Only 3 shots to destroy it and get me the final token so I can leave. Another fun level, but that tree were a pain though. Level 3 is a boss level, Bombs Away. We're still in the gardens when a remote control plane flies in. Gotta wait for it to get close and shoot it. Japan never changes much apart from its altitude and it takes about 10 shots before it goes down. That's the first proper boss, a bit tedious honestly, just 2 minutes of repeating the same strategy every few seconds. They also managed to pick the smuggest possible screenshot of Buzz for the boss defeated screen. That face manages to convey all the smuggitude of Rosen's voice.
Now perhaps you understand my earlier warning.
I also get awarded the bonus clip from the film, but I don't want Disney kicking my door down, so let's just move to level 4, Construction Yard. Right away after starting, I turn and find the foreman, who's lost his 5 little tykes. And Potato Head says I need this disc launcher to defeat the level's boss, but I need to find him his missing eye first. Since there's some free time, here's another bit of deep backstory for you. This is one of those levels that stayed in my head for years, not even because of this game. So in 1999, the year before I got this game, I started to get into Dragon Ball and really hoped for a game to come out. I didn't have the internet back then and didn't get game magazines very often either, so I just didn't know there were a couple in the UK. But I was playing this game at the time, so my imagination just kept giving me this exact level, but with Goku over Buzz and that image stayed longer than the real level. Isn't it weird what stays with you? So I go in this work shed where someone's deserving of a criminal negligence charge what with all this acid lying around. I climb up onto this desk on the top of the filing cabinet with the drawers that open and close on their own and save the first tyke. Next to it is a colour mixing challenge, make the colours on the sign to get a token. I make all 3 and I've already got my first token in this level. After I leave the shed I push a box to get another tyke on top of the wheelbarrow. Next I find Slinky in the middle of all this concrete. He challenges me to find 5 wrenches and bring them to him within the time limit. 50 seconds, easy. I get it done with 10 seconds left and get my second token. I climb up the digger and find the third tyke on a seat. I then press a switch to activate the scoop. With it moving I can now get on this girder and start scaling the building. On this first row of girders I find the fourth tyke and press a switch to activate a lift at the bottom that will bring me back to this spot. I take this beam up to the second row and press another switch to bring the lift up here too. Upon the third row I find Potato Head's eye and activate one more switch so I can return here before diving down to the bottom. Thankfully there doesn't seem to be fall damage in this game. I give Potato Head his eye back in exchange for a disc launcher. Picking it up gives me 10 discs to shoot. While I'm down here I also get the token for 50 coins from him. Back at the building and I make it to the top. I find the last tyke off to the side and challenge the jackhammer boss. No special strategy, just run away and fire a disc when it's safe. When he's done I get the token and jump down, return the tyke to the foreman for the last token and leave. This one was alright. Level 5, Alleys and Gullies. And right away I'm finding another item I can't use yet. But this time there's no way around it, I'll have to return later to fully finish this level. This level is also memorable to me for less happy reasons. It was while backtracking to this level that our original PlayStation started having a couple problems. I can't remember exactly what happened, but I just remember it making a shrill noise. I think it only took a few weeks to get sorted out, but back when you're 7, that's an eternity. I go to the end of the alley, zipline over to this dustbin and into the street. I climb this melon stall and jump along these shelves to a switch that makes this fan move. I get onto this awning and find I can't do anything because I don't have the item. Instead I grab onto this balloon, that is blown by the fan over to this dustbin with the first token on it. So I go back in the alley and talk to the giant rubber duck who's missing its 5 ducklings. I go to the other side, push this wood over to make a bridge to push this box over to the fence. I jump over and find this sewer area. I cross the boards and get to Slinky in the middle. He wants me to gain 5 bones this time, and right away I fall in the water and ruin it. I get it the second time though and get a second token. Back to the other side of the level and I get the last coins needed for Ham and this duckling nearby. Luckily he's right below me and I can get my third token. Sadly that's all I can do right now and I have to leave. Now it's time for level 6 and the second proper boss, Slime Time. As you can guess by the name, it's a big pile of slime. I have to keep shooting it to shrink it enough to do damage. I have to be quick though since he does grow back. This was a better boss fight than the last one, being less repetitive and only needing 5 hits to kill. Moving on to level 7, Owl's Toy Barn. First thing I find is Potato Head on top of one of the counters missing his arm. I also find that Owl also has acid on his floor as I suffer my first death in the game. I go towards the back, bounce from the trampoline on top of the shelf, make my way to the zip line and jump off into this counter to get the arm. I give it back and Potato Head lets me use the rocket boots. I think you can guess what they do. I press this switch to start a timer, use the boost to get to the shopping trolley, bounce up and make my way to the other end where I find a chick. I go further back and into this room, dodging the basketballs, climb up and go through the bike wheels, climb up and go through some more wheels, find a second chick, jump on this skateboard and ride it across the acid where I find the mother chicken. I then push this box all the way down this aisle, climb up on top of this shelf to push another box down and push that all the way to the other side to get up on another shelf and get the third chick. I go even further into the back where I find a chicken challenging me to get to its hatching egg in time. It involves going all the way down the zipline I used to get a Potato Head's arm. It's really easy though, I had 32 seconds left when I got the fourth chick. I go back to the chicken who says the time limit will be shorter, but this time there's a token inside. Despite some slip-ups, I managed it on the first try and got the first token of the level over 10 minutes in. Next I go past the chicken into this room and use the disc launcher to shoot the locks off his filing cabinet and climb up the drawers to get the second token. Next I go into the other back room and find one more item I can't use yet. In here, Rex straight up tells me I can't get the last chick without that item, so that's most of the time spent in here pointless. I go through the event and face a dinosaur boss, this one I drain most of itself standing and bottom mashing. Probably the easiest level boss so far. With the third token obtained, I return to Ham and get the fourth token and leave. To be honest, finding that out about the chick after getting all the others warmed me up a bit, but at least I'll have some nice music. Level 8 is Owl's Spaceland. First thing I do is go into this arcade area and use this claw machine to grab the first token. I ran into this silence, run across the bars to his top shelf, and then jump across to another shelf with a shield, which I used to survive all these laser shots coming from the box Emperor's Ergs, climb up more boxes, and ride a pair of zip lines to the first of five little green men. Jump over a few more rows of boxes to find the second and push this box over to create a shortcut back to this end, which is where Ham is. Now it's time for the next aisle, jumping across more shelves until I run into UFO challenging me to a race across the zip lines. The zip lines are marked red where you should jump to the next one, I just narrowly win it, and on the way I get enough coins for Ham. Once I grab the token, I also jump over this gap for the third little green man and then get the third token off Ham. I start climbing up this big planet displaying at the fourth green man. I then jump into the side area where I meet the second boss who still thinks he's a space ranger. No blue utility belt, but he does have a car. It's another boss where just mashing fire defeats him easily, getting me token 4. Finally, I return to the arcade, get on top of one of the cabarets and jump into the ball pit where I find the last alien, return it to the mothership for the last token and leave. Nice to be able to fully finish the level in one go again. Level 9 and boss 3 is Toy Barn Encounter. It's this weird chandelier UFO, showing it opens up one of the capsules to release enemy. It's a different enemy every time. Once they're all gone, it's just a case of dodging its laser and shooting it until it dies. Level 10 is Elevator Hop. Within seconds of starting, I find Potato Head wanting his missing shoe for a grappling hook. I feel like I'll be getting the better deal here. I go into a power room and swing up to the top of this generator, jump across the gap and find it. I return it to him and get my grappling hook. To use it, I just have to go into first person aim at a target, then fire. I get to the top and start going through the vents. Next to Rex, I find the first of his levels collectible, Wind Up Mice. I go up even more vents and finally make it to the top of the level. I press a switch to activate a shortcut from the bottom and meet the mother mouse. In this room, I also find the second mouse and press switches to line up these wires, which opens the door to the lift and gives me my first token of the level. Now there's these two lifts moving up and down in this room, and there's a lot of jumping between the two and waiting. I get to the top and collect the third mouse. I also press a switch to create another shortcut here from the bottom. In another vent at the top is the father mouse. He makes a token appear and I have to catch it before time runs out. I keep missing it and going too far ahead the whole way down, and I only get it right at the bottom with 3 seconds left. This dropped me at the bottom, so I visit Ham and get the third token and the mouse I missed the first time I was in here. I go back to the top of the lift shaft and go through another vent to find the spider gun robot boss. Once again, matching fire does the job, except for when I die because I went into the fight with literally no health. That's token 4, now I just need to find the last mouse. Turns out it was on a random bit of wall in the lift room. Now I can return them to their mother, get the fifth token and leave. And good too. This was probably my least favourite level in the game. It's really dull, there was so much boring grappling and lift jumping to do. But since I have the grappling hook, it's time to go back and finish level 5. The grappling hook lets me climb this ladder, and now I'm going to skim over this because this part was a massive pain in the ass for me, falling all the time and getting lost in all these identical platforms. This was my second least favourite level for this part alone. I find the last duckling, get the rest of them and return them for this level's 4th token. Then finally get to the top of these apartments to fight the clown top boss. Same strategy kills it and I'm finally done with this one. Level 11, Owl's Penthouse. This level was as far as I got as a kid, I just couldn't get enough tokens to go further than this. Right away, Bullseye already knows Buzz, can talk, and challenges me to bring in 5 horseshoes within the time limit. But I only get one before giving up and deciding to explore the level first. I'm in my way to the top of Al's living room and press this switch to destroy the cannon he has on his table firing at me. I then jump over this gap to a shelf with the first of Jesse's 5 missing critters. I shoot open the lock on this cupboard, creating a passage to his bathroom. I turn the tap on his bath and flood the place. You thought things didn't end too well for Al in the film itself, just wait till he gets home. I then turn on the sink tap and flood it some more. Yeah, this place is fucked. I destroy another cannon at this point, why not just go all the way and just ruin this place by turning on the shower too? It was all worth it for this one collectible. It's all okay though because I can just press a switch on the bath and drain everything and everything will be alright. That's how it works. Now let's do this horseshoe thing right and get my first token. I push this box into the room with Al's woody collection, climb up, push this box and use it to get over the gap, and make my way across the shelf until I find the third critter and destroy another cannon. From there I jump into this model town to fight the gunslinger boss. It just takes 5 shots to get me the second token and I destroy another cannon. I take that box I pushed in here and this time bring it to the train room, so now I can use it to get on Al's train bed and get the fourth critter. I then start pushing this box from one side of the screen to the other while pressing switches to stop the moving model train from crashing into it. After getting it towards the bed, I climb up to the top, destroy one more cannon and pick up the third token. After that, I return to the bathroom to get the coin token from Ham and finally, going into Al's kitchen. Where I shoot the lock off the fridge, jump up the shelves to the table to the sink, make my way to the other side and bounce up to the top shelves, jump across the lights, get the last critter and hand it over to his terrifying Jesse for the last token. I caught a lot of slip-ups, this level took me nearly half an hour. It was fine though. Now I'm in completely new territory, starting with level 12, the Evil Emperor's Erg. In a bold shake-up, he's immune to my laser, only spinning my wings into him will hurt him. He'll rise up, fire a shot and lower himself to be hit again. That's it, and about 10 hits later, he's falling off the edge. The last trio of levels now, starting with level 13, Airport Infiltration. I start off under the conveyors and bounce off a suitcase on top of one. Followed by jumping between them by getting on top of a suitcase and swinging across until I make it to the end and bounce off another suitcase to get higher up to even more conveyors. While climbing up these I get my third death in the game. After the conveyors is more climbing to a zipline to one more conveyor with another tag at the end. This level's collectible. I drop down to the bottom and run into Rocky Gibraltar, the muscle man toy people don't remember unless reminded of him. It wants me to get 5 weights in the time limit. I fail the first time with 4 out of 5 though. Next to this luggage stack, Potato Head's wanting his lost mouth for the last power-up. The other room has a broken plane to climb. After climbing up the wings, I find the mouth. I get to the top but can't get any higher without last power up, so I spike to Potato Head to give him his mouth and get the hover boots. I use them to get to the top of the luggage stack and jump to another conveyor to fight the prospector boss. Jump whack, repeat, win, get the first token. From there I can climb further up to reach a zipline to get one last conveyor with the second tyke, then it's doing Rocket Challenge properly for the second token. I'll climb back up the plane and I find a third tyke on one of the engines, then it's using the hover boots to get to the top of the plane for the third token, I then get the fourth tyke on the way down. Back in the first area I find the final one above the conveyors. Near it I also find Ham and get the fourth token from him, then it's finally returning those tykes to their pilot for the last token. It was better than the last mostly vertical level, but it still took forever, thanks to all the falling down that plane I skimmed over. Now that I have the holo boots, I can go back to level 7 and get those chicks again, use the holo boots to get that last chick, return them all to their mother for the last token, and finish off this level. Now into level 14 and the last full level, Tarmac Trouble. This is based on the rescue sequence with the plane at the end. First I decide to go around the outside of the level. Not long after I get the first of this level's collectible, a suitcase with a face made of stickers. Eventually in one corner I can climb up to a zipline and write down to a colour matching game. I have to make the two rows of lights match with only 3 button presses. As you can see here, the hardest part of it all is the camera doing its hardest to not look at the lights. It's only now I have to change the camera mode, it hadn't been this bad until now. Getting it right makes this helicopter drop the first token of this level. In this driver's seat I find the second suitcase and in the next corner I run into the tyke I'll need to deliver them all to. Having circled the outside I go toward the centre, there I run into Slinky once again, who wants me to reach the end of this winding path without jumping or touching the slime. I've got over a minute to do it but that's plenty of time and I get the token with 19 seconds left. I then climb the flagpole next to Slinky and jump on the plane that's been circling the level the entire time. On top of the cockpit I find the third suitcase, and since I'm so close by when I jump off, I get the coin token from Ham. I find the fourth suitcase by getting back on the plane and waiting for the wing to pass by it. It's also how I find the fifth one, I return them all and get the fourth token. Back on the plane again and just past where I find the last suitcase, I jump off and find the blacksmith boss. He's like Zerg in that he can only be armed by hitting him with my wings. He has these projectiles that go along the floor that I have a really hard time dodging, which gets me my fourth death. Plus HP doesn't replenish so one hit later he's dead, getting me the 50th and final token in the game. Which leads me to level 15, Final Showdown. I found Terrifying Jesse and Dopey Woody, but Stinky Pete along with the Gunslinger and Blacksmith bosses come out of this suitcase. This does mean that the final boss is just 3 previous bosses copy-pasted, but the change in attitude of the plane at least makes things a bit more challenging. After taking out the Gunslinger, the Blacksmith's presence gets me my 5th death. It goes down next door, leaving the Prospector easily dealt with, but the Blacksmith did wear me down enough again that Pete could get one last kill him while he was a hit from death. But that doesn't save him. Oh, homie, I get awarded a clip from the last scene of the film, and afterwards I'm given a message congratulating me on completing the game, and then the credits. And that's Toy Story 2 Buzz Lightyear to the Rescue, and another bit of closure for me. I was half expecting this game to not hold up after a bad experience with another PS1 platformer I'll get to in a bonus video, but a few annoying moments aside, I had fun revisiting this game. I wouldn't say it's anywhere near one of the best 3D platformers, but it's a good one. If you want a fun 3D platformer and see it cheap, I'd recommend picking it up. It's also on the N64, Dreamcast and PC, and I don't believe there's any huge difference between them gameplay-wise. Hopefully I'll do more Toy Story games in the future, but right now this is the only one I own, but at least I own a good one.